on a beautifully bouncy brown Bakerloo line train heading northbound to the end of the line to the top of the Bakerloo to do episode 14 at Harrow and Wealdstone. Harrow and Wealdstone is the end of the line for Bakerloo services. It does, of course, go further if you're travelling on the London Overground up to Watford, and the station is also situated on the West Coast Main Line, with fast trains passing through and stopping trains also calling here. The station is also Grade 2 listed, with an entry on the Historic England database officially listing its ticket office range, platforms, waiting room blocks, canopies, and the linking pedestrian bridge that spans all the platforms.
Ah, I was hoping for a nice day, alas. It's a little bit drizzly, a little bit cold. The Bakerloo line train has just terminated here on platform one. Yeah, platform one. It then goes into a siding and then reverses and comes out back into service over there on platform two.
What's interesting is that Harrow and Wealdstone used to get six trains an hour, one every 10 minutes on this part of the line. But since May 2021, that's been reduced down to just four Bakerloo trains per hour, one every 15 minutes. The majority of the tube trains terminate at either Queen's Park or Stonebridge Park. And there's also the often forgotten about hourly Southern train that calls here. You can go down to East Croydon via Kensington Olympia from Harrow, which always feels like an unusual but fun route to take.
So I'm coming out the side entrance here, which is off of platform one. There is a main entrance, we'll get to that in a second, but the reason why I come here, rather excitingly, oh, daylight, is because there is, of course, a car park here, and that's a pertinent phrase, because from now on, and I'll splash it on screen, we are going to be playing until the end of the series, which will probably be around episode 20. We're going to play end of the line bingo, as we did with Lost Railways and the allotment phrase. I think car park is the key phrase in end of the line. So there's a grid on screen, I'll put a link in the description. You can download the bingo sheet, and basically anytime I mention a word in the video that's in the bingo sheet, you can tick it off. And will there be a video, I hope so, where I say all the words and you can then call bingo for the entire sheet. Car park is one of the words. I think zone 6 is one of the words, but you can't have that because Harrow is in zone 5, not zone 6. But I'm just aware that I've said the phrase zone 6 twice, three times now, so you can include that, tick that off. I don't think I'll be saying all the words in this video though, but pay attention, it'll probably happen. Let's go and have a look around Harrow.
And by Harrow, I mean Wealdstone, and the obvious first thing to see outside the station is the Wealdstone Bridge mural. It was created in 2004 by local schools, and it shows scenes, buildings, and businesses that have been here since 1800, and how the railway has been an integral part of that. There's also this respectful memorial which remembers the Wealdstone railway crash, which happened here in 1952.
So I've gone for a 10-minute walk north of the station, away from Harrow, into Wealdstone, heading north up this way because, and I'll explain when I get there, did you know in Wealdstone there is an actual stone, a wheeled space stone, and you can see it and you can sit in it and it's right there. This is the Wealdstone, that's it, right there, outside the Bombay Central Restaurant, which I think used to be a pub, is an old sarsen stone, which if I quote from an excellent Londoners article, which I will link to below, written by Matt Brown, hi Matt, he writes, "The Weald part of the name is an old English word meaning wooded hill or high land. So the Wealdstone is the stone from the wooded hill. The rising ground to the north of the stone is indeed still heavily wooded." So if you want the full history and the speculation on where it's from and how it got here, go and read Matt's Londonist article. I will link it in the description. It is excellent. But yes, Harrow and Wealdstone really does have a stone that is a Wealdstone that is right there. That's it there.
And then another brilliant fact, which you may not know, is that Harrow and Wealdstone may just be the oldest station on the network.
So if you know your London Underground history, and as a regular viewer to my channel, I hope that you do, I'm sure you'll know that the Tube first opened in January 1863. So you could say that the first ever stations on the Tube were from then, 160 years ago now, 1863. Except, what about stations that are now used by the Tube, the underground system, which were built before 1863, and Harrow and Wealdstone is one of them. In fact, there's a whole list, and I'll give you the top three, because there has been a National Rail, British Rail station at Stratford since 1839. Ealing Broadway was built in 1838, but this, Harrow and Wealdstone, and there's a plaque on the side there which gives the date, July, was first opened by the London and Birmingham Railway. This was the first stop north out of Euston, opened in 1837. That predates the opening of the London Underground by 26 years. So yes, they added new lines to it in, like, I think about 1917, but this technically does mean that officially this is the oldest building that is now used by the Underground, a tube station, and it dates from 1837. Now, Harrow and Wealdstone is also, I think, the longest dead end that you can make on the underground. What I mean by that is that if you exclude connections, interchanges with overground stations from Paddington, there's 13 stations from Paddington up to Harrow and Wealdstone, so it doesn't connect with any other underground line, and I think that's the longest chain of pure tube underground stations that you can take without it connecting with any other underground stations. If I've got that wrong, I'm sure you're telling me in the comments right now. Also, I mean, when you get to the top here at Zone 5, Harrow and Wealdstone, it's got lifts. It's like a rare thing, a Bakerloo line that has step-free access. That's because it is also a national rail station. There's six platforms, there's lifts to all the platforms. And to get to the lift from the ticket office, you walk down this corridor here and right past this bit here, which I've mentioned before in my Lost Railways of London, because this is the old abandoned platform that used to go to Belmont and Stanmore. So look in the corner for a link to that video if you've not watched that Lost Railways of London video, and then come back here and watch all the end of the line videos. So abandoned platform.
One final moment to admire the juxtaposition of the fast Pendolinos versus the 50-year-old Bakerloo line stock, and I was on my way home.
We are leaving Harrow and Wealdstone. That is the end of the line here, up in Zone 5, top of the Bakerloo in Harrow. There is a playlist coming up on the title card end screen in a minute, which has got all the episodes previously and future ones coming back if you're watching this at a later date. So make sure you watch the whole of the end of the line series. Thanks for watching. See you again soon. Bye.